All right, I was just watching reporter Danny from the West Wing smooching C.J. Craig just the other night. We know him for that role, for Poindexter on Revenge of the Nerds, and, of course, the great work in 30-something. Here's Timothy Busfield from upstate New York. Timothy, nice to see you. You tell me, do you ever look back? Do you ever look at these old roles?
Hi, Sam. Thanks for having me on. Yeah, you know, we were going to do the 30-something reboot. And, you know, when that was going on, we watched the episode. We watched several episodes again. Melissa, my wife, put these on, and we were watching them. And I hadn't seen them in a while and was surprised how much they held up and exactly how thin we all were. And the West Wing, I really, you know, I didn't understand the show when we made it. It was all over my head. So I was just focusing on CJ and trying to act like I, you know, not bump into the furniture. I mean, Aaron Sorkin, I love him. I look back at, you know, I've had a very fortunate career. Yeah.
Dule Hill was talking about, and I thought this was so wise, how we miss the voice of the West Wing.
Well, you know that, you know, I asked Carlo Guthrie one time, what was it like with Dylan and the Beatles and all those guys? And he said, the songs came through everybody. He said, we were just kids and we played all day. You wouldn't have attributed, you know, so many of these guys the skills of being master songwriters. And Aaron, you know, at a young age, writing all that stuff, it was just coming through him. And I was staying at his house a lot when we were doing the show. And those episodes just, I don't know how he did it. They just, they sort of just came through him. And that voice that was created with Dee Dee Myers and Tommy Schlamme ran the show was just sort of a, you know, lightning strike. And we were all very fortunate to have had it.
You reference your wife, Melissa Gilbert. And the story here that during quarantine, you guys have a bear that keeps coming to the backyard?
Well, first of all, I'm blowing a kiss to my wife. She's out there, actually. Yeah, you know, my wife is like sort of Snow White. You know, I mean, all the animals, she fed a deer out of her bare hands the other day, and I got footage of it. We got chickens. We got porcupines. They all come into the yard. You know, she has that half pipe thing. And at one point, I hear, you know, bear. And I'm like, honey, what are you doing? And she was like, no, it's, look how cute. And she's like, I think it wants to, like, you know, us to feed it. And I said, yeah, it wants your, it's checking your blood type, probably, is what it's doing. Get away from the bear. But that's just her. She's that person. She's just that girl on Little House. She's pretty amazing.
Let's talk about For Life. We've had Aaron Wallace on the show. You tell me, does this matter more to you? I mean, it's such an amazing story and, in essence, based on a true story.
It's, you know, first of all, to be a part of this show at this time is really a spectacular. I mean, I love it every day, and I bug Melissa constantly with the new script and what's in it. You know, we have an opportunity here. Sonny Hoffman just wrote episode 7. I just read it, which is Black Lives Matter, which is we're sort of able to deal with a lot that's happening right now and put it into our stories, which being up and running in production and then ahead of it all, it's really exciting. And to track Aaron as he gets out of prison and starts to help other prisoners out, it's a really cool series, and I'm very happy to be on it.
Timothy, you've done a lot of good work behind the camera as well. Is it this shorthand, because you've had so much experience as an actor, enables you to be a good and effective director?
I think it really helps. My favorite directors are all really good actors. You know, Sidney Pollack and Redford and those guys that I've worked with for the most part, you know, that I didn't work with Sidney Pollack, but certainly Redford and the actors on, you know, 30-something and that directed, you know, it does help a lot if you know the shorthand. You're absolutely right. You know, Ron Howard, I just think it really helps if you can act to understand what the actors are going through. So often there is either that director or the director that says, stand here and say this, that's your job. And it's like, well, there's holes. First of all, typhus isn't airborne. How do we fix that? You know, that kind of thing. What? How do I make this play? Some sensitivity, you know, from the director on what you might be dealing with, whether it's a doctor show or a you know, legal show. You want some understanding.
Timothy, it is great to see you. I'm glad things are going so well. We'll tell folks that season 2 of For Life will premiere tomorrow at 10 on ABC. Morning News takes a break here. Busy Tuesday. We're back with more, including You Want to Make $500? Those code words are on the way.